Good morning. So this is Reshma. Today I'm continuing with another topic in design and analysis of algorithms, that is Hamiltonian cycles using backtracking. So before continuing with Hamiltonian cycle, I just to recall the backtracking technique which we have already discussed in previous videos. So now if I recall, backtracking is an algorithmic technique which is used for solving the problems recursively by building the solution incrementally, considering one element at a time, and while constructing the solution, if we found any solutions which are not satisfying the conditions, we need to remove those solutions. And this can be implemented by constructing a state space tree. And for the construction of state space tree, we have to use DFS technique, that is depth first search manner will be used to construct state space tree. So that is, the state space tree will be constructed as a choices being made by the user. And the structure of the state space tree is like this. So this is already discussed. So again here, this shows the root and the last nodes represent the leaves. So now here the root is a node which is the starting point of our state space tree, and we need to represent this before starting our solution. Before the search of the solution begins, I need to represent this root node. And the leaves represent either the dead end or the solution. So in this structure, so here we have three dead nodes and two solution nodes. So now between this root node and the leaves, we are having intermediate nodes at different levels. Now at level 1, elements of the first choice, level 2, second choice, level 3, level 4. So like this, in between root and node, we are having different levels. And based on whether the nodes in the intermediate level leads us to the solution or it leads just to the dead end, so based on this, the nodes are considered or categorized as promising node and non-promising node. So for example, here in promising nodes, I have indicated using green color. So this indicates, this corresponds to the partial solution which is constructed, and this node leads to the solution. So the nodes which leads to the solution are referred to as promising nodes. So now here for second solution one also, so all these green color nodes are promising nodes. But the non-promising nodes are the nodes which doesn't leads to the solution, it just leads to the dead end. For example, here if I see this yellow color node, see here, if I continue from here, I'm not getting the solution, it just lead to the dead end. So promising nodes are the nodes which corresponds to the partial solution and it leads to the solution. Non-promising nodes, these are also the part of the partial solution, but they does not leads to solution. So now if I found a promising node, for each promising node I have to create a child, then create its child, and I have to continue till the leaf node. But once I get a non-promising node, for example, if I get a non-promising node, for example, if I take this yellow node as a non-promising node, then first I have to backtrack to its parent. From parent, try to find the next option. So here I got next option, this yellow, this is also a non-promising node. Again, for this I have to backtrack. Once I get some non-promising node, and if it is not having any other option to continue towards the leaf node, then I have to backtrack to its grandparent. So like this, for example, if I come here, first I have backtracked to parent, there is no sub option here, backtrack to its grandparent, that is one level up. Again for this node, there is no other option towards the downwards, then again I have to move upward. So like this, for promising node we have to move towards the solution, for non-promising node I have to backtrack to its parent and this will continue. So like this, once I go through all the elements of the given legitimate input in the construction of the state space tree to find the solution. So this is the structure we'll get at the end. So now we'll try to solve the Hamiltonian cycle problem using this backtracking, that is by the construction of state space tree. So before that, let's see what is Hamiltonian cycle. If we recall graph theory, there we have studied different concepts like circuit, path, cycle. Okay, so among those, if we go for a cycle, so cycle is a path where there is no repetition of vertices and it has to start and end with the same vertex, then the same cycle we can call it as Hamiltonian cycle, that if it covers all vertices. So I can redefine Hamiltonian cycle as, Hamiltonian cycle is a path traveling from a node back to itself, because this is a cycle, where every vertex is visited. We have to visit every vertex and that visit should be only once. So Hamiltonian cycle is a path traveling from a node to itself where every vertex is visited exactly once, then such cycle is called as Hamiltonian cycle. So now some graphs, if they may have Hamiltonian cycles or Hamiltonian cycles may not be available. So now if a graph has more than one node and if it has an Hamiltonian cycle, then we can call such graph as Hamiltonian graph. So now here using backtracking technique, we'll find the graphs, we'll try to apply the Hamiltonian cycles method and we'll be finding whether the graph is Hamiltonian graph or not, means whether the graph contains Hamiltonian cycle or not. So now the graph may contain one or more Hamiltonian cycles or Hamiltonian cycles may not be present. So if we found some Hamiltonian cycles, just we need to print as the solution for the Hamiltonian cycle problem. So now to begin with, we'll see some of the examples of the Hamiltonian graph. Now if I see this, so here I have started with this node, then we are visiting each and every node, so like this exactly once, and we are finally coming back to the same node. So this is one example of Hamiltonian graph which contains one Hamiltonian cycle. So now these are some other examples which shows the Hamiltonian graph. For example, here if I take this graph, so yes, this is Hamiltonian graph because this contains Hamiltonian cycles. So for example, I start from here, one second vertex, third vertex, fourth vertex, and finally comes back to the same vertex. Now again here, if I start from here, one like this, the red color line indicates the Hamiltonian cycles in the given graph. See, each vertex is, every vertex is visited and exactly once, and finally coming back to same vertex. So these are some graphs, examples for Hamiltonian graph which contain Hamiltonian cycle. So now using backtracking, so let's find, solve this Hamiltonian graph. So now means try to find all possible Hamiltonian cycles for the graph given here. So now we have to construct state space tree to find the Hamiltonian cycle. Then how to start the state space tree? We have to start with the root node. For example, if we take starting node as A, I have to take that as the root node. So now state space tree in backtracking is constructed in the form of DFS. So that is depth first search. We have to increase the depth starting from root towards leaf. I have to move from root to the leaf. That is, this is top down approach. So now for that, first I need to find adjacent vertices for A. Adjacent vertices for A are B, C and D. Among B, C, D, the first element in the alphabetical order is B. So from A I have to move downwards towards B. Then for vertex B, adjacent vertices are A, C and F. But vertex A is already visited here, then from for B I have C and F as adjacent vertices. So first I have to move in alphabetical order, that is B to C. Now from C I have A, that is B, D and E. So B is already visited, so I have to select either D or E. In alphabetical order, D come first, so from C I have to continue to D. Now from D I have A, C and E, but here A is already done, C is already done, then I have only one option, E. Now if I go to E, so we have C, D and F. So here C is already done, D is already done, so from E I have to move to F. So now we have already visited all the vertices. Now I have to check, can I move from A to, from last vertex F back to vertex A. So now for F I have B and E. So now for F I have B and E, but B is already visited and E is already visited. So I can't continue from vertex F to A. Please, okay. Then this F form a dead end. So now here what I have to do? So these becomes the non-promising nodes. So I have, as I am not getting the solution from vertex F, I have to backtrack to its parent. So now from E, I need to check, is there any other option? From E, adjacent vertices for E are C, D and F. So here for E, F is done, C and D are already visited. So there is no option from E. So what I have to do, I have to move one step up in the tree. Okay. So now again from vertex D, I have to check for the next option. For vertex D, possibilities are, adjacent vertices are A, C and E. A is already visited. So C is already visited. For D here, just I have to check for E also. So there is no option again for vertex D. So what I have to do, again we have to backtrack to its parent. Okay, now again check, continue with checking for C. For C, adjacent vertices are B, D and E. So here B is done, D is already done. So now for C we have other option, no need to backtrack to its parent. I can continue with the next option of C. Next option of C is here, E. Now if I go to E, adjacent vertices for E are C, D and F. So C is done. Now we have for E two more options. I can move to D or F. So I have to first move to D in alphabetical order. So D to D. So now from D, adjacent vertices for D are A, C, E. E is done, C is done, A is done. So now here we have to check the vertices from that particular node towards the root. From root to that particular node, whether it is already visited or not, that we have to check. For example, here D, adjacent vertices are A, C and E. So I'm just recalling here. For D, E is already visited, C is already visited, A is already visited. So we have to backtrack. Now if I continue with, now I have to come for E. Vertex A, E, adjacent vertices are C, D and F. C is done, here D is done. Next remaining vertex is F. From E we have to continue to vertex F. So now again for F, adjacent vertices are B and E. E is already visited, D, B already visited. So what we have to do, this is a dead end because this will not lead to the solution. I have to backtrack to its parent. So now backtracking to the parent E, again check for the option for other option for E. This we have already checked. For vertex E, options are C, D, F, but here C is already visited, D already visited, F already visited. So no other options for E to continue towards the solution. Again I have to backtrack to the next upper level in the tree. Similarly from C, if I check, for C options are B, D, E, all are visited. So again backtrack to its parent B. Now for vertex B, adjacent vertices are A, C and F. Here A and C is visited, remaining option is F. Now from F, B and E, B is done, we have to left with E, so we'll write here E. For E, C, D, F. For E, C, D, F, here we have not yet visited C, either C or D or F, so C will come as a first option in the remaining element, so I have to write C. Now from C, adjacent vertices are B, D and E. So here B and E are already visited, remaining vertex is D. Now from D, adjacent vertices are A, C, E. C and E are already visited. So A is already also visited, but as A is the source and all vertices are already visited, so I can move back to the source vertex, that is to the same vertex A. So now this forms the first solution, because Hamiltonian cycle states I have to start with one vertex and come back to the same vertex by visiting all the vertices exactly once. If I see this path here, I have visited all the vertices like A, B, C, D, E, F. All vertices are visited and each vertex is visited exactly once. And I have started, as I have started with A, I have ended with the same vertex A. So this path forms a first solution, Hamiltonian cycle 1. So now we may have more than one solution also. So now we'll try to continue with the remaining options and try to find either any other Hamiltonian cycle or not. So now here for vertex A, I had option A, B was already used. So now other option is D. For A, I'll continue with D. So now for vertex D, options are A, C, E. A is already done. From C and E, I have to select the first option. First option in alphabetical order is C. Now from C, B, D, E. So what which vertex I should take? So now from C, the next vertex is B. Similarly, if I go for B, then just follow the same method. Next vertex becomes F. Then to E. So from E, I don't have any other options to go back to vertex A. Even though I have visited all vertices here, but there is no option to move from vertex E to A. So this forms a dead end. Once I get the dead end, so this becomes a non-promising node. So first move back to its parents. Then if there is no option, then again I have to move back to its one level up. Next one level up. So like this, once I get the option, I have to take that as another subtree. Now similarly, D to C, C to E. From E, I have got the option F. Next option for F is B. Then next option for B is A. So that is, this forms a second solution. If you want, we can just verify here. I have started with vertex A. If I go for this path here, all vertices are visited. Just check here, A, B, C, D, E, F. Yes, all vertices are visited here and each vertex is visited exactly once. And finally, I'm going back to vertex A. So starting from vertex A, coming back to same vertex A, visiting all vertices exactly once. So the condition satisfied here. So this is another Hamiltonian cycle. So solution 2. So similarly, try to find the next Hamiltonian cycle if available or not. Follow the same step here. I'll be just going for the E slide. You can just recall and check why the next node is coming here. D to E, C, E to C. Check with the graph. C to B, B to F. So from F, I can't go back to again vertex A, source vertex. This form a dead end. So then backtrack. So one by one backtrack. So once I reach the source vertex A, once all options for all vertices are done, so then this shows, this is the completion of the construction of state space tree, and we can find how many solutions we got. So here I got two solutions, that is two Hamiltonian cycles. So what are those two Hamiltonian cycles? A to B, B to F, F to E, E to C, C to D, then coming back to vertex A. So this is one Hamiltonian cycle. Second Hamiltonian cycle is A to D, D to C, C to E, E to F, F to B, then finally back to, this is second Hamiltonian cycle. Just we can see whether how it will form a cycle. Starting from vertex A, then I have visited B, from B to F, F to E, E to C, C to D, D to A. This is one Hamiltonian cycle. Second one is A, starting from A, A to D, D to C, E, F, B, A. So these are the two Hamiltonian cycles for the given graph we have found through backtracking technique. So if you have any doubts in Hamiltonian cycles problem, please ping your questions to my website and subscribe to the link to get the next videos related to backtracking and then design and analysis of algorithms.